You're watching Adorama TV.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to this week's episode of Adorama TV iPad application review. Well, this week we're looking at an application called Filterstorm 2. Now, we've looked at a lot of applications that allow you to add effects and edit photos on the iPad. This one is one that I think stands above and beyond the rest. It allows you to do all kinds of things, including upload your images to an FTP site. There's so much to this application that we really want to dive in. So let's take a look at Filterstorm 2. Filterstorm is an application that has all kinds of things that will allow you to edit pictures. So it's broken up into a left-hand side that has all of your controls and the right-hand side that has where the photo will be when you edit that. Now, to start out with, there are some video tutorials that you can watch that go into really great detail on how Filterstorm 2 works. We're going to just show you some of the features of Filterstorm because it has so many, we can't make it through all of them in this video. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to hit load photo, and then I'm going to go in here to one of my photos here, and I'm going to get this photo that I took, and this is one of our models, Deska, and I chose this photo on purpose because the color temperature is wrong and it needs some color correction, as well as I have a color checker passport here by X-Rite, so I can show you how you can do some things that I've never seen in an iPad application before. So before I do that, let me go through how these adjustments are organized. On the left, you have the canvas tab, and in the canvas tab, you can crop, scale, rotate, straighten, and flip an image. So let me go through those really quickly. So to crop an image, you hit crop. It's going to give you an option to do either the original ratio, or you can set a ratio that's specific to your needs. Once you have that set, you can say crop, and then it gives you these tools so that you can go in changing the size, and then moving the crop, and then when you get it to exactly where you want it to be, you touch crop, and the image is cropped. Now, the nice thing about this is that at any point, you can go back in time and you can undo things. So I can hit this little watch right here, and it shows me all of my last steps. And so I'm going to go back here and hit this. That's the last place I was, and bam, there's my picture all back to where I was just the step before. Now, scale, what I can do is I can put in a specific width or height, and that's really nice if you're putting a photo on a blog and you need it to be a specific width or height, or you're going to email it or something like that. So you can actually resize by pixel, which is really, really nice. The rotate feature does just a simple rotation either to the right or to the left. If you want to straighten your photo, then you hit this straighten tab, and what that will allow you to do is rotate that in just small increments, and so it's straight just like you want it. And then flip allows you to flip things left to right, right to left, or up, upside down, etc. Those are very, very straightforward. Now, the other thing that you can do here is you can go into the filters. Now, the filters are where all the power lies in this application. So you can go in here and you can change your luminance, and look at that. You actually have curves, so you can change this curve by dragging it down, dragging it up. You can add points to this curve. So if you want more than one point, you can do that, and then you can really change your contrast by doing this. So this is really good. So simple controls right here, brightness and contrast, more powerful controls there if you are familiar with curves. And the other thing you can do is you can apply this with a mask and then just paint in those areas that you want to change with those curves, so it doesn't apply it to the entire photo. And that is true with almost all of the filters. You can apply a mask and then just paint that in. So I'm not going to apply that. I'm just going to go here to the hue and saturation. Now, here's something that's really cool. Notice I have this temperature slider. Now, I want to really make sure I set this color temperature over here accurately, so I can actually drag this over, and I see on my color checker passport, that's where middle gray should be, and then it adjusts the color there. I can adjust it either cooler or warmer, and now I have fixed my color. And just to prove to you that this is actually working, I'm going to drag this up here to a color that's really not right, so this blue, and you can see it does the opposite. It gives you this really nasty tone here, so I'll go back here to a gray. And this is something I've not seen in an application for the iPad, where you can actually change the color temperature of your photo. That's really, really nice. You can also go in, so I'm going to apply that so that it's nice and my color is correct. I can change this to a black and white image. I sort of like that, but look at this. I can actually do filtering based on red, green, and blue. And so, sorry about that, I can go in here and take this slider and slide it more so I have my reds a little bit the luminance up or down on the reds. Same with the greens or blues. So if you're familiar with more advanced black and white conversions, you have this in this application. So again, this is something that I've not seen on an application for the iPad before. It's really, really nice. Now I'm gonna say, there's one more thing I can do this. I can say apply and paint color on black and white. So I can now go in here and paint in some color on her lips. I can paint this in. And so this is, you know, one of those things that many people like to do with photos. They can go in there and actually change that. You can change the opacity. There's just a lot of stuff that you can do. There's a bunch of tools here that we don't have time to go through, but there's some really, really strong features of really fine tuning how your filters are applied. I'm not gonna hit the check mark here, which is the okay. I'm gonna hit X because I don't wanna do that. I just wanna keep it black and white there. Then there's a bunch of other things I can do here, adding vignettes, colorizing it, posterizing the image. I can do all types of things there. We don't have time to go through all of those, but they're very powerful tools. Now, what I can also do is I can add metadata to this image. So I can go in here, I can put my headline, my ITPC title, my caption, keywords, instructions, etc. Now, this is really powerful if you're uploading photos to an FTP site. That's right, you can actually click this button and then you can save this to your photos, you can save it to your photos and then email it, or you can save it to your photos and post it to an FTP site, and this supports up to 3 different FTP sites, and so you can export it as a small, which is an 1800 pixel preview image, 1800 pixels on the long side, or up to 3072 pixels, which is a much higher resolution image. So this is something that really sets it apart from other applications. Now, I'll show you one other thing. I can hide this bar if I want to go in here and look at my image and see how that's doing. But to set all those FTP filters and settings, what I can do is I'll exit the application, I'll go back here, and I'll go into my settings on my iPad. And then if I go down here to my apps, I can go to Filterstorm, and you see here, there's FTP Server 1, FTP Server 2, FTP Server 3. You've got all kinds of different things that you can save here as your preferences and presets, metadata settings. All of that stuff is built in. And so when you're using your Filterstorm, it has all of that. And so it saves you a lot of time. So that's Filterstorm 2, a really powerful image editing application. Well, that's Filterstorm 2. As you can tell, that app is really loaded, lots of features. In fact, there's so much that we didn't get to all of it in our review. Well, if you'd like to see more iPad applications, just go to the Adorama Learning Center. There's a bunch of our reviews there. And if you have questions about photography or apps for the iPad, you can send those questions to me at askmark@adorama.com. Well, thanks for joining me. I'll see you next week.
This episode is brought to you by Adorama TV. Visit the Adorama Learning Center, where you'll find photography tips and techniques, links to the gear used in this episode, and related videos. For all the latest photography, video, and computer gear, visit Adorama.com. And the next time you're in New York City, visit our store, located on 18th Street between 5th and 6th Avenue.